Welcome back to Hannity. The city of Chicago was rocked over the holiday weekend by an outbreak of violence. According to the Chicago Police Department, 7 people were murdered and a total of 48 people were shot just between 6 p.m. Friday and 12 a.m. Sunday night. It's been reported by the Chicago Tribune that among those killed was a 7-year-old boy who was shot while watching fireworks. Joining me with reaction is Milwaukee County Sheriff David Clark and from the Manhattan Institute, Heather McDonald. Sheriff Clark, my hometown, Chicago being renamed Chi-Rac. What the heck is happening there?
Yeah, 80 miles up the street from Milwaukee. It sounds like the killed and injured toll that we'd hear after a blast out of Ramadi or Fallujah. We wouldn't expect this coming out of a great American city like Chicago, Baltimore, New York, Milwaukee, but this has become the norm, and it's these failed social engineering experiments that are masquerading themselves as criminal justice and prison reform, things like alternatives to incarceration, community corrections, deferred prosecution, second chance, where they create a revolving door, Eric, where the police go out, they get the bad guys off the street, they're put into the criminal justice system, and then the criminal justice system has a revolving door where they spit them back out with low bail, like I said, deferred prosecutions, back into these struggling communities to claim more victims. And often, and this is why I think these experiments are cruel and discriminatory, they're killing good, law-abiding black people.
Mm-hmm. Heather, you know, I remember last year we thought the shooting incidents in Chicago were elevated. Take a look at this full screen we have right here. In 2015, 1,045 shooting incidences from January till June 28th. Last year, only 866. We're up almost 22 or 23% versus a very violent year last year.
Well, you know, what's been happening, Eric, is this specious movement called Black Lives Matter, whose thesis is basically that the police are the biggest threat facing young black males today. There's been nonstop demonization of law enforcement from the highest reaches of government. I include the president in that. And police are second-guessing themselves in interacting in high crime neighborhoods because they're worried about getting caught on a cell phone using force against somebody who's resisting arrest. The cell phone video is not going to capture the entire interaction, and police are backing off. And as Sheriff Clark says, it's the law-abiding residents of these communities that most need the police to protect them from the epidemic of kids being raised by without fathers that is the real root cause of the violence we see in the black community. The Black Lives Matter movement was a fraud. Nobody's going to be out there protesting the death of 7-year-old Amari Brown. Nobody protested when a 6-year-old Marcus Johnson was killed in St. Louis in March. Everybody was still converging on Ferguson, Missouri. Black lives only matter, it seems, when the police shoot somebody in good faith, not when it's a thug. Yeah.
Sheriff Clark, would you agree? A lot of the black community is saying we need to spend more money in Chicago, but it doesn't matter how much money you spend in Chicago. If the parents aren't providing guidance for these kids, you're going to have an elevated crime rate no matter where you are, Chicago or elsewhere.
Right. There's a lot of self-inflicted pathologies and maladies going on in these American ghettos. As Heather indicated, things like father absent homes. But then there's things too like failure to embrace education, ineffective parenting, which you just made mention of. And you mix that together with this failed social engineering experiment of criminal justice and prison reform, where they're trying to eliminate the use of jails and prisons as an effective crime control tool, and they are. And you have this volatile mix, and then you have these weekends. But it's not just weekends anymore. We saw what happened in Baltimore over Memorial Day. But like I said, here in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, my hometown, 11 separate shootings, 7 people dead, including a 14-year-old boy. And as Heather indicated, where's the outrage? Where's the uproar? It's only when the police have to use deadly force, and most of the time, an overwhelming amount of the time, it is a justifiable use of force. But that's what the left goes after because they know.
You know what else, Sheriff? I'm going to play some tape here. But you know what else is another factor? Resisting arrest. For some reason, now it's becoming the thing to do to resist arrest. Take a look at what happened in New York. I believe it was over the weekend. Take a look.
You can give me check my ID and all that. You got my ID.
Yeah, exactly.
Come on, man.
This is some man.
No, you're not gonna do that to me. Stop it, man.
Yo,
you're not gonna do that to me. Understand? You're not gonna do that to me. Come on, why are you doing that to me?
Back.
Nah, get the out of here, man. Nah. Come on, get my dog, man.
Okay, so that was released over the weekend. The gentleman in the red shirt had an illegal knife. The cop said, you know what, I want that ID, I want that knife. He resisted arrest, and there was a fist fight. Thank God there was no shots fired, but let me tell you, Sheriff Clark, quickly, and then Heather, I don't have a lot of time. Weigh in on the new wave of resisting arrest.
Well, no respect for authority. That emanates out of the homes. I've said before, if we want to end these deadly encounters or reduce them, then when a law enforcement officer gives a lawful command, do it.
All right, Heather.
Well, Sheriff Clark's right. It emanates out of the homes, but it also emanates from our politicians who are saying the lie that the police are racist. And that is hurting police officers in the street who are encountering more resistance from people who have been fed the lie that the police are out to get them. That is not the case.
I'm going to leave it right there. Thank you very much, both of you. Coming up.